Hi everybody, this is Shivakumar Reddy and welcome to the session of Fundamentals of Transformers. In this session I would like to introduce the phasor diagrams or vector diagrams also. First of all, let me define the transformer. It is basically a static AC machine which is going to convert the voltage levels from one level to the other level. That means from high level to low level. It is known as step down transformer, and when the voltage is converted from low level to high level, it is known as step up transformer. Now let me briefly explain the working principle of a transformer and also its EMF equation. Transformer works on the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. Basically, that is a statically induced EMF. Here we have got primary winding, secondary winding. Generally, primary winding is connected to supply voltage and secondary winding is connected to the load. E1 is the EMF induced in the primary winding and E2 is the EMF induced in the secondary winding. And when supply is given here, a small amount of current will be flowing through the primary winding, which results in the development of a flux. Here the core is used as a medium for the flow of flux between primary winding and secondary winding. The second primary winding turns are considered as N1 and secondary winding turns are considered as N2. When this flux is going to link with the windings, obviously EMF is going to be induced. Let us consider the flux as phi is equal to phi m sin theta, because we give alternating supply here, AC supply. Hence the flux is considered as phi m sin theta reference, where theta is equal to omega into t. Omega is the angular velocity and t is the time. Then according to Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, the second law, that is the EMF induced is given by minus N into d phi by dt. So when you consider the primary winding turns, this formula becomes minus N1 into d by dt of phi is phi m sin theta, and this is equal to, phi m is a constant, you can take it outside, minus N1 into phi m into d by dt of sin theta, which gives cos theta into d by dt of theta is equal to omega t. And this is again dt by dt of omega t is omega, minus omega N1 phi m into cos theta. And here this can be written as minus omega N1 phi m, cos theta can be written as sin of pi by 2 minus theta, and this minus is taken inside. We are going to have omega N1 phi m into sin of theta minus pi by 2. So as this is the EMF equation of the primary winding, it is considered as E1. E1 is equal to, let us consider this is the maximum value, and let us consider this maximum value as E1 max sine of theta minus pi by 2. Let us name this equation as number 1. The same principle is going to be implemented for the secondary winding also. Here we are going to have the same equation for the secondary winding also, but the only thing is we are going to have N2 in the place of N1. So that I am going to consider it as E2 max sine of theta minus pi by 2. Let us say this is equation number 2. Here the maximum values are, one is E1 max, another one is E2 max. Let me write down separately these maximum values here. We have got the The formula for E1 max is equal to omega into N1 into phi m. And that is omega, we know that omega is known as 2 pi into F N1 into phi m. For sinusoidal alternating quantity, the relationship between maximum value and RMS value is given as E1 maximum is equal to root 2 times the RMS value. Root 2 times the RMS value. Let us consider this RMS value of the primary winding, RMS value of induced EMF of the primary winding as E1, capital E1. Here I am writing this as capital E1. Then the value of E1 is equal to E1 max divided by root 2. Here E1 is the RMS value of primary induced EMF. So E1 is known as the RMS value of primary induced EMF. And this is equal to E1 max divided by root 2. And E1 max itself is 2 pi F into N1 into phi m divided by root 2, and this gives you a value of E1 is equal to, if you simplify this, we are going to have 4.44 into pi m into F into N1. So this is known as the EMF equation of a transformer. And similarly, we are going to have the same derivation for E2 also, except it will have N2 in the place of N1. So I am writing equation directly for N2, E2 also 4.44 pi m F into N2. Now, again I am writing down these two equations. Here, E1 by N1, this is going to be equal to E1 by N1 is equal to 4.44 into pi m into F, and that is equal to E2 by N2. It means to say that the EMF per turn in the case of transformer will be the same in both primary and secondary windings. Hence, we can write this as equal to E1 by N1 is equal to E2 by N2, which gives rise to E2 by, from this I can write as E2 by E1 is equal to N2 by N1. And this is known as turns ratio or voltage ratio of a transformer. And generally, it is going to be represented with a small k. For step-up transformers, this value will be greater than 1. And for step-down transformers, this value will be less than 1. Next, let us see the introduction to vector diagrams. First, we have considered the flux as phi is equal to, I am writing down the equations here, phi m sin theta. The equation for induced, primary induced EMF E1 we have got as E1 max sin of theta minus pi by 2, and similarly E2 also. Similarly, we have got the value of E2 is equal to E2 max sin of theta minus pi by 2. So here these are the maximum values, and if you consider flux as the reference vector, with respect to flux, E1 and E2, they are going to have a time difference of, or a phase angle difference of minus pi by 2. So here you can see, if it is sin theta, this here we are going to have theta minus pi by 2. It means to say that there is a phase lag of minus pi by 2 for E1 and E2 with respect to phi. And when it is represented as a diagram in the space, we are going to have, say this is the So I am drawing the first phasor diagram for this. Let us say phasor diagram number 1, considering flux as the reference. So let us say flux phi is the reference vector. Then E1 is going to lag behind the flux. E1 is going to lag behind the flux by 90 degrees or pi by 2 radians. Similarly, E2 also will be lagging, and the magnitude or the length of the vector is going to represent the magnitude of the induced EMFs E1 and E2. For step down transformer, E2 will be shown with the smaller length compared to E1. For step up transformer, E2 will be shown having larger length with respect to E1. Next, let us see ideal transformer. Let us consider an ideal transformer. This is the symbolic representation of an ideal transformer on no load. Let me recollect the conditions for ideal transformer. Generally, no transformer will be ideal. All the transformers will be having certain amount of losses. But for our analysis, we consider that the ideal case of a transformer which has got the efficiency as 100%. So efficiency is going to be 100% means there are no losses, any kind of losses will be absent here. And when the transformer is connected to the supply, it is going to draw very, very negligible amount of current in order to establish the flux from primary to secondary. Means whatever current it is going to draw here, let us say this current as I0, and this current is going to be drawn from the supply, it will be very, very negligible, and it is used for magnetizing the core or to establish the flux in order to create the induced EMFs E1 and E2. Generally, this I0 is a no load current because we have not connected any kind of load onto the secondary side. Is going to be only magnetizing mode, and there are no other losses, and this magnetizing component of current is also very much negligible. So once we consider these ideal conditions, next we can go for the representation of vector diagram for this case, that is ideal transformer on no load. First, let me draw the reference vector flux phi. So this is the reference vector phi, and once we represent flux, the next thing is to represent the induced EMFs, and we know that E1 is going to lag. Already we have represented here, we have proved that also why these two are going to lag behind the flux by 90 degrees. So let us say this is E1 going to lag behind the flux by 90 degrees. Similarly, also E2 will be lagging behind, say this is E2, and once we represent E1 and E2, we know that the primary voltage V1 is going to be equal to the same of as that of the induced EMF on the primary winding, that is E1, but it will be in opposite to that. V1 is going to be equal to minus E1. When it is represented in a vector diagram, it is going to be, so if this is E1, minus E1 will be exactly of same length but in 180 degrees phase shift with respect to E1. So this is V1 is equal to minus E1. V1 is equal to minus E1. After that, we need to represent the no load current I0 here also. We know that this current is utilized for creating the magnetic flux phi. Hence, this will be in phase with the phi. So, this will be in phase with the phi. Now, this vector is going to represent I naught or the magnetizing component of no load current. Thank you for listening to me. In the next session, we shall go with the other phasor diagrams related to the transformer, considering all the practical problems. Please subscribe to my channel for getting more updates. Thank you.